In the last few classes, we had looked at non-dimensional thrust and ISP for cases wherein the efficiencies were all unity, right. Let us now look at the case where efficiencies are not equal to unity, and let us see how the equations change there. Now if you look at the TS diagram for a turbojet with efficiencies, what you will let us consider only the simple cycle, no afterburner. This is a cycle with 100% efficiency. Now if you have non-unity efficiencies, now if you have non-unity efficiencies, you will get a cycle like this. The dashed ones are for non-unity efficiencies. Now when we did the analysis for a ramjet, we saw that we were able to handle efficiencies of the non-moving parts, namely intake, then burner, then nozzle, right. Here in addition to these we have the compressor and the turbine, okay. So in addition we have good thing about this is we are going to look at it in two different ways. We are going to handle efficiencies with related with the non-moving parts in the same way as we did in the ramjet analysis. That is, we are going to look at intake, burner and nozzle the same way as in ramjet. Here we are going to look at it a little differently, okay. Just to refresh your memory, the intake efficiencies can be varying from 0.6 to 0.9 and is a strong function of the Mach number. Then we have compressor efficiency which can be of the order of 0.82, 0.87, then the burner is 0.932, 0.95, then turbine efficiencies and finally nozzle efficiencies of the order of 0.1. Okay. Notice one thing, that both these two are lower than these two, right. There is a difference between the two of them, that is both these have an adverse pressure gradient to cope with, which is why they will have a, typically diffusers and compressors will have a lower efficiency compared to turbines and nozzles. Okay. Now let us do our cycle analysis. Cycle analysis, the expression for thrust per unit mass flow rate, right, or non dimensional thrust, what is this expression now? This is the same as earlier, that is T7 minus by T naught into right. This is for optimally expanded flow in the nozzle. Okay. So therefore P7 is equal to P0, so that term vanishes out, the pressure thrust term vanishes out. We have to find expressions for these two ratios. Okay. To find expression for T7 by T0. Before we go there, let us first look at what is different from the all unity cycle. Now if you remember in the previous case when we analyzed ramjet, efficiencies we dealt with slightly differently. We said for the non-moving parts, if you look at intake, burner and nozzle, we included the efficiency terms in the pressure cascading. The reason for that being that if you assume that it goes to the same stagnation temperature, let us say we are looking at intake on a TS diagram, if you are looking at only an intake process, this is for 100% efficient cycle. Now the assumption that we made was a non-isentropic process would go something like this to 2', wherein the temperatures are the same, the stagnation temperatures of 2 and 2' are the same, only that these pressures are different, right. These are constant pressure lines, these are different, and therefore we looked at handling this terms with only efficiencies coming up in the pressure terms. Fine.
Sir, we are assuming that at the end of the diffuser the flow is at most stagnation, it is not stagnation
No, we, when?
At the end of diffuser intake, two point. Two. So two, we are assuming that it's a stagnation temperature. Okay, but we know ST naught is the content of energy in the flow.
Yes.
Okay, if some losses are there, so energy should not be equal to the ideal energy. Like ST naught of the ideal is not equal to ST naught dash.
True.
So how can we
see in real systems what we look at is when we are looking at an intake. Okay. If the process were isentropic, you would have a certain pressure recovery, okay, at the end of the isentropic compression, you would have a certain pressure recovery. If the process is real, what is the pressure recovery or what is the pressure at the end of such a process is what you are looking at. So from that perspective, if you look at this, here you are trying to capture what is the pressure recovery. This efficiency would then indicate whether it is 100% efficient, 90%, 60% efficient. The pressure terms contain the efficiency part, right. And here if you look at this case, we have only turbine and compressor to take care of, right. Now in the turbine and compressor, what we do is we know that the power of the turbine, the work or the power produced by the turbine must be equal to the power consumed by the compressor, right, because of the balance between the two. So if you remember, we did not say tau c and tau t are two different things, we tried to combine them through one equation. So if we take efficiencies of turbine and compressor there, we are going to complete the cycle. So even in this analysis, we will carry out cascading, wherein we will deal with efficiencies in terms of pressure for the non moving parts, and when we come to the compressor and turbine, we look at what happens between the power or the compressor and the turbine with efficiencies. Okay. Now if you look at compressor turbine power balance, or before we go there, how are efficiencies defined for the compressor and turbine? Eta c is defined as TT3 minus TT2 TT3 dash minus TT2, okay. And similarly, the turbine efficiency is defined as TT4 minus TT5 divided by TT4 minus TT5 dash. Okay. This is obvious from this figure, where this is TT5 dash, this is TT3 dash. Okay. So let us now try and do the cycle analysis and try to get these two ratios. So from here, if we are going to do a similar analysis to what we did in ramjet, okay, would whatever we had derived in the previous classes for T7 by T0 be any different? See, compressor turbine power balance will consider efficiencies there, but otherwise in the temperatures while cascading, we do not look at efficiency. True, but they appear as tau c and tau t, right. If you look at the expression, they like appear as tau c and tau t. When you include that power balance, tau c and tau c t cannot be independent terms. So when you include them in the power balance, that is when you get the real expression for both of connecting both of them. Okay. So let us do the cascading. So firstly, cascading temperatures. Okay, we want an expression for T7 by T naught, similar to the previous cases, T7 by TT7 into TT7 by TT6, TT6 by TT5, TT5 by TT4, TT4 by TT3. Okay. Now, as in the previous case, what is this? This is a ratio of stagnation to static, so I can express it in terms of Mach number. This is flow through jet pipe. This is one. Now this is flow through nozzle, 1, this is flow through jet pipe, again 1, this is pi t, sorry, tau t, and this is flow through the main combustor, 1, and this is tau c, this is 1, flow through intake, and this is theta naught, right. So it is similar to what we had earlier derived, that is, sorry, this has to be TT4 by tau b, and then if we put it in terms of theta b, the expression that we get is, we know that tau b and theta b are related, that is, so from here I get tau b would be equal to theta b by tau c theta naught, and if I substitute it, finally I'll get T7 by T naught is equal to tau t tau c this and this cancels out, I get okay. Now I need an expression for Mach number ratio, which I will get by cascading pressures. So we know that P7 by P naught is equal to 1, is equal to P7 by PT7 PT7 by PT6 into PT6 by PT5, PT5 by PT4, Now when we cascade pressures, if you remember what we did with ramjet, we will get efficiencies here. So this is 1 is equal to 1 by 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 m7 square into pt7 by PT6, this is flow through nozzle. So this has an efficiency, that is the nozzle efficiency, okay. Now flow through the jet pipe also has an efficiency, let me call it eta JP. If it is on, it will be different value, if it is off, it will be a slightly different value. Then what is this, PT5 by PT4, this is pi t into eta burner, this is through the combustor, then this is through the compressor, so this is pi c, this is intake into theta naught to the power of, right. Now just like when we did ramjet analysis, we will club all these efficiencies into one and we will define theta eta as if I define it this way, I can express all the terms here as a power of gamma by gamma minus 1, okay. This is just the intelligent way of putting it here, so that we will get the same powers. So pi t I know is nothing but tau t to the power of gamma by gamma minus 1, I will put all of them, so I will get 1 plus m7 eta tau c theta naught, okay. If you look at this expression, we wanted in the denominator that value, so we have got this, so now I can write T7 by T naught as equal to okay, which I can cancel the tau t terms, write it as theta naught. Now we are interested in Mach number ratios, and the other thing that I know about is 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 m naught square is equal to theta naught. So using these two expressions, I get the Mach number ratio as m7 by m naught is equal to eta tau t tau c theta naught minus 1 okay. Now we know both the ratios, temperature as well as Mach number, So we substitute them in the equation and find out how it looks like. So when we put them in this non-dimensional thrust equation m dot a naught, we get m naught eta b by eta If we put efficiencies is equal to 1 here, we recover back the turbojet equation, right. So we have put this as equal to 1, which is what is the turbojet equation, right. Now we need to find an expression connecting tau c and tau t, right. So this comes from compressor turbine power balance, we get m dot a Cp Tt3 dash minus Tt2. This is the actual power consumed by the compressor. This must be equal to m dot a Cp Tt4 minus Tt5 dash. This is the actual power delivered by the turbine, okay. So here we have assumed Cp to be constant. Yes, you can take a mechanical efficiency which will turn out to be that you will have to take one by mechanical efficiency here. You can include that, you can assume it to be 1. If you want to include it, you can put it here, okay. So Cp is equal to constant, and the other assumption is that, I am sorry to write here 1 plus f because there is a larger mass flow rate, and the other assumption that we will make is f is very much less than 1, okay. Now using this we will get, we also know how to connect efficiency of the compressor to this, right. If you remember what was the efficiency, Tt3 by minus Tt2 divided by okay. So I get, I want this term, so I will get it as Tt3 minus Tt2 divided by eta c, and similarly turbine efficiency was Tt4 minus Tt5 dash divided by okay. So if I take these efficiency terms into account, these equations will, we will be able to rewrite as follows. I think this mechanical efficiency needs to be included here and not here, because if mechanical efficiencies are non-unity, which is less than 1, then the compressor requires more than what the turbine can give, so you have to include it here. Okay. So it will be, if you cross multiply, it will be a fraction, compressor will only get a fraction of what the turbine develops, okay, fine. So where does mechanical efficiency come in here in this equation, right, fine. So we are interested in tau c and tau t, so to get that, we divide both sides by T naught. TT4 by T naught minus TT5 by T naught. What is TT3 by T naught? TT3 by TT2 into TT2 by T naught, right. What is this? TT2 this is 1 for flow through diffuser or intake, this is, what is this, tau c, and this is theta naught. So this term becomes theta naught, and similarly on this side, what is TT4 by T naught, this is theta b, and this term would be TT5 by TT4 into TT4 by T naught, okay. So TT4 by T naught is theta b, this is, so tau t into theta b. So we get theta naught by theta b into eta c, eta t, eta mechanical or tau t is equal to one minus theta naught by theta b Now if you look at this expression, what happens if efficiencies are not equal to 1, then this term increases, right, and you will get a lesser tau t, fine. That means that you will have lower and lower pressure at the end of the turbine. Fine, is that correct? Sorry, if you have unity, you will have theta naught by theta b into tau c minus 1. But if you have non unity, then what happens? This term is large, and therefore 1 minus this will be small, which is again what I said earlier, that is correct. So you will get tau t to be small, fine. And when tau t is small, the pressure ratio, the pressure at the end of turbine is low, and sometimes if the efficiencies are very poor, one might actually end up having a turbine at the end of which there is no power left for there is nothing left for expansion through the nozzle, which means there will be no thrust that is produced. So one needs to be careful about efficiencies here, so that we do not end up in such a situation. Now we have been able to derive expressions for non-dimensional thrust for all situations, that is efficiency is not equal to 1, efficiency is equal to 1, and optimally expanded flow as well as nozzle being choked. And we have also looked at afterburner, without afterburner, and what is the other mode of water methanol injection, also we have looked at, right. Now here in this case ISP by A naught that does not change, the expression does not change, but F by M dot A naught will be different, because you now have efficiency terms coming in, okay. The expression for ISP by A naught would be I think we need to derive this. See, there is efficiency term involved, and therefore the TT4 by because of which we need to re-look at what is the ISP expression. So if we look at ISP by A naught, we had in the previous classes looked at this expression. This is 1 by F into F by M dot A, A naught, okay. Now how do we get 1 by F? We get 1 by F by looking at the energy balance across the burner. So from across the burner I get M dot F into Q is equal to M dot A into 1 plus F . Remember in the earlier expression that we wrote, when the efficiencies were 1, we were looking at TT3 only, right? Because if you look at what happens due to non-isentropic process, this temperature would be higher than or different than the earlier temperature. So you have a situation wherein this is different, so therefore that will come here, right. So we make the assumption that we had done earlier, that is f is very much less than 1. So I can take out this quantity and I get my expression for 1 by f is equal to Tt4 by T0 Now we know that compressor efficiency is eta c is equal to Tt3 minus Tt2 okay. So using this
Sir,
huh?
Tt4 by T0 minus Tt3 dash by T0 will be in 1 by this.
Oh, sorry. Thank you. This goes to the denominator, so it will be thank you. Okay. We know efficiency is denoted in this fashion, so I can connect from Tt3 dash to Tt3 here. So 1 by f is equal to q by Cp T0 before I do that I will just do a small manipulation with this expression Tt3 by Tt2 minus 1 into Tt2. I can write this expression, rewrite this as this, and Tt3 dash by Tt2 minus 1 this and this cancels out. I am interested in this expression, so I will get Tt3 dash by Tt2 as equal to okay. So Tt3 by Tt Tt3 dash by Tt2 would be 1 minus what is this Tt3 by Tt2? This is tau c. Okay. So, sorry, 1 plus this goes here, you get this. Now we have been able to get the expression for Tt3 dash by Tt2, we can use it here and we can write TT3' by T0 as equal to this expression is what we have derived just now. What is this? This is nothing but theta naught. So I get TT3 by T0 is equal to tau c minus 1 divided by eta c. Into theta naught. So finally, my 1 by f term comes out to be 2 1 plus tau c minus 1 okay. This is the expression that we get. So what happens to if you plug this in the ISP by A naught expression, you get ISP by A naught is equal to Q by CP T naught This is the expression that we get for ISP by A naught. Now if you see in this expression, what happens if eta c is not equal to 1? This part increases and therefore theta b minus this would be small, right. So can I now say it is advantageous to have a non-efficient compression process? If you look at this expression, it's in a sense it disguises some things. We have not written the full expression for f by m dot a naught, wherein efficiency terms are also there, right? If you look at this, it appears as if this part will be reduced, will be increased, and therefore the entire term will be smaller, and as a consequence ISP will be higher. But if eta c becomes large, is a low value, not large, it is a low value, then what happens is the pressure ratio across the compressor or the pressure at the end of the turbine becomes smaller and smaller. You will not have any power left for expansion through the nozzle, right. So although it looks very deceiving here, it is not the actual case. You need to plug in the values for eta c and other things into this expression and then see how it looks like. We will look at it in the next class. Thank you.